Let's meet the Wood family. Kim, Wendy, Sandy, Jim, and Bill, ready for action. Playing against the Mulligan family. John, Susan, William, Charles, and Charles. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello. Hello. The Wood Family. How are we doing? Are we feeling good?
Yeah.
We've got a great crowd. We've got a great home viewing audience. And I've got $5,000 that I want to give away to the most deserving family. Who might that be? We'll see. Right now, let's meet our returning champions. Say hello to the Wood family. Sandy, how are you today? You know, you deserve that because yesterday, you got 200 points all by yourself. Makes up for the choking in the time of season. You have $6,589 and four wonderful teammates who are?
This is golfer extraordinaire, my husband who just won a golfing tournament.
What would his name be?
Bill Wood.
Bill?
Yes.
Thank you.
Good just to make sure you have
we'll
other
talk
ones.
More, Bill, about your golfing in a little bit. Who else we got?
And this is my quiet and shy daughter Wendy.
Yesterday she was your sister. Yes. Today she's your
well,
daughter.
Well, and then this is Miss Bashful and blushing Kimberly. Yeah.
How are you?
And then last but not least is my son-in-law Jim, who is also our friend.
Good. Also your friend?
Also our friend. You betcha.
Okay, I believe you. You sold me on that. You're playing against the Mulligan family.
Charles, how are you, Ernie?
I'm very fine. We're very happy that we have your family on our show.
Thank you.
Who'd you bring?
I brought my son, John.
Hi, John.
How you doing, Ray?
Good to see you.
My daughter, Susan.
Nice Hello. To meet you.
My son, William.
Hi, William.
Hi. And my son, Charles.
Hello, Charles.
Hello, Ray.
I want you to relax, and I want you to have fun, and I want to play the feud. Sandy, let's go. Come on, Charles. The first family to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play fast money for the $5,000. All right, there's a ding to start the game off. We ask 100 people this question, and we have the top six answers on the board. Try to find the most popular. Name a kind of place that people go to whether they want to or not. Sandy.
Doctor's office.
Let me see the doctor's office.
Good answer.
It's there, but one answer will beat it, Charles.
Jail.
How about about jail? That's a good answer. Didn't make our survey. Think of a steal.
Okay.
Bill, now she said you just won a golf tournament.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank
Which
you.
Golf tournament was that?
Sheriff's golf tournament.
So you're in the sheriff's department?
That's right.
And what's your handicap?
A 16.
16?
Yes, going down, unfortunately.
And going down. You know, I was in a golf tournament, and I was down to the final. It was the last hole I had a chance to win. I lined it up. I was feeling good. I hit it, and right as it was going right for the cup, that windmill came around and hit it and knocked that ball. It was going right for the mouth of the clown, and that windmill hit it.
Sounds like the same place I won mine.
Right, that's right. Anyway, can you name a kind of place that people go to whether they want to or not?
Cemetery.
Oh, Bill, it's nice talking to you. Let me see.
Come on, guys.
The cemetery. Funeral. It's on our survey. Not a good answer, but it is a good answer. Wendy, got an answer.
Come on, Wendy.
I got an answer.
All right.
Probably sounds pretty bad, though. Church.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
What church do you go to?
We don't go.
Okay, all right. But if you did go, it's not because you don't feel forced to go.
No,
but
no.
You, okay, let me see a church. Oh, 16 people go to church, 5 have funerals, I guess 11 getting buried right at the funeral home. Okay. Kim.
Ray.
Kim?
Ray.
All right, Jim. Kim?
How about a lawyer?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes
answer.
You have
Good
to
answer.
See
right.
a lawyer.
All right. All right.
Okay. You might get a chance to steal here in a minute. Jim, what do you
How
say?
Doing,
How you doing?
Just fine. How you been?
It's really, really good to see you again.
Thank you.
I've been fine. A kind of place that people go to whether they want to or not.
The dentist.
Whoa. Oh.
Come on. It's up there. Number one.
The dentist. Mulligans, you're going to get a chance to steal if Sandy cannot tell me a kind of place that people go to whether they want to or not.
Okay, I would never want to go to a courthouse.
But sometimes you have to.
Sometimes.
Okay. Let me see you to stay alive. Courthouse. Not there, Mulligans. The most popular answer in all the survey is sitting right there. Name a kind of place that people go to whether they want to or not. Charles?
Ray, I'd say school.
School.
Work.
Work?
Work.
Susan, work?
School.
School. Charles, you got some choices. You can go out on your own. We've got three answers. One is the most popular.
I'll say school.
You say school.
All right.
That is a good answer. We will see if it gets you the bank. Show me.
School.
I can't believe it.
Yeah, I can't believe it either, but again, it seems like work. Nobody that I know really loves to go to work except for me, Gene Wood, and our judge, Howard Felcher. We're the only three people. Show me number one. Work. Number four. Grocery store. Your apology. You don't apologize. That was a good try. Number five. In. Makes a lot of sense. We're going to come right back. Don't go away because we're going to have a lot of fun. Hi, welcome back to Family Feud. Right now, the Wood family has $41. Everybody back.
All right.
I'm in control here. Right now, the Wood family has $41. The Mulligans have zero, and it's time for another face-off. Let's go, John. Let's go, Bill.
I can't wait. Nice to meet you.
I'm trying to show a little authority here, guys. Just because I took the suit off, don't think that you're a police officer. You can push me around, Bill. All right. Are you ready, John?
I'm ready.
Your family is down, and you need to... I'm going to give you a practice swing because he's been here before. Go ahead. See, you're really slow. I beat you left-handed. Try it again. All right,
gotcha.
Close, you got it. All right, here we go. We've got the top five answers on the board. We asked 100 people. Name something specific you ask a waitress for.
Coffee.
Let me see. Coffee. Yeah. It's there. One answer will give you control, John.
The check.
John says the check.
Set.
Oh,
all right. Okay, guys.
Good try.
Come on.
Wendy, something specific you ask a waitress for?
Water.
Good answer. Good.
Let me see water.
Thank you.
Woo! Yeah. Something specific you ask a waitress for?
Ketchup.
Okay, let me see.
Yeah.
Ketchup. Oh, yeah. Give me number five. You got a clean sweep and you have the bank.
Menu.
Yeah.
Makes a lot of sense. You might have that bank.
Come on,
number five is a menu.
Eggman.
The feud's begun, but we're going all the way to $300 and we're going to try to give away $5,000. So come on back. We are back. Right now, we're having fun in the feud. The Wood family has $125. The Mulligans have zero. Come on, it's time for another show.
Nice. Good luck.
I believe the question, both clear your minds and concentrate. The dollar value is doubled. We have the top six answers on the board. Name a food that comes in instant form. Susan.
Cereal.
How about some instant cereal? It's there, but one answer will give the Wood control, Wood family control. A food that comes in instant form.
Rice.
Instant rice.
Aww.
For the Mulligan family. Calm down, Wood family. Think of a steel answer over there. They seem confident. Hey, William.
How are you?
How you doing? It's a pleasure. I haven't had the chance to get down here today. Where does your family hail from?
For the rest of the show, though.
You got that accent. Come down here for the rest of the show.
You will.
Where are you from?
Massapequa, New York.
Did you come all the way out from New York to be on the show?
Yes, we did.
Minneapolis.
You did?
Area.
Well, I didn't ask, but I'm glad, Susan, that you told me. Now, the rest of the family came from New York, and you met them here.
Yes.
Well, these are some of the... We're happy with all the families we get. You saw an ad in New York, and you went in an audition?
Susan saw it in Minnesota for contestants in New York.
Okay.
So she used our parents' address, and that's how we're on the show.
Well, we really do appreciate it, William.
Oh, I appreciate
Now, let's see if you can win this game. Give me one of the answers that are up there. The most popular is sitting there. Name a food that comes in instant form.
All I can think of, Ray, is Chinese noodles.
Okay. We flew him out from New York all the way, paid airfare and everything. You're paying for the rental car, William. We're not going to pay that. I mean, that's the kind of answer you're going to give. All right, Chinese noodles?
Right.
Possibly number one answer. We're going to see if Chinese noodles are there. Show me Chinese noodles.
Oh. I really thought it was there.
I can't believe it's not there. I don't know who it's serving.
Charles,
you know what?
Hello, Ray.
It's hard to tell you guys are even related.
Yeah, that's what everybody said.
Now, you're brothers?
Yes.
Who's the oldest?
I'm the oldest.
By how long? Susan, once again, I'm not talking to you, okay? I don't want to bring this up. Talking to William, you jump in. I go down to Charles, you jump in. Talking to him, you don't say anything. Susan, just imagine you're in Minnesota right now. Just imagine that. Okay. Charles.
Name a food that comes in. I love this family.
How about mashed potatoes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The crowd's behind me. A low five by my kind of guys. All right. Show me instant potatoes. Number one. Charles, you got to be proud of this. You're kind of like the JR or the Jocko of this clan.
I am.
Now, Mulligan, you are obviously Irish.
Oh, yes.
All right. Maybe you could give me one of those three answers.
Coffee.
All right.
All right. All right. The question is to name a food that comes in instant form. We'll see if it made the survey. Show me coffee. All right. Okay. All right. Is that a food? Gene Wood, is that a food? Sitting down to a big bowl of coffee and just eating it? Juan Valdez and his family? John?
Ray, I'm going to say soup.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. It's got to be there. Show me soup. Give me one answer. Susan, I love you. I'm teasing you, but I want you to know now is your time to talk. And if you can happen to come out with number four, your family's going to be in this game. I'll ask the question, a food that comes in instant form.
Cookies.
Instant cookies. All of a sudden, she has memory lapse. So right. You got that bank if number four is cookies. William, bring it home for the Mulligan.
Win it for it.
TV dinners?
TV dinners, he says. It's a good try. If it's there, you got the bank. Show me TV dinners. Wood family, you can take a big bank. Name a food that comes in instant form, Jim. Doesn't know, Kim.
Pudding.
Wendy.
Baby food.
Baby
Hot
food.
Hot chocolate.
Hot chocolate.
Pudding.
Couple different
pudding.
Answers, Mom.
Pudding, Mom.
I hear them chanting pudding
on
your baby food. What are you going to say?
Pudding.
What
I have to do pudding.
Pudding.
All right.
Milk.
You say you have to do pudding, but you really wanted to do milk.
Instant milk,
okay.
Powdered milk.
Show me for that bank pudding.
Come on, come on, come on.
There, you've got the bank. $281 for the Wood family, the Mulligan zero, let's go. Time for another face-up. Come on, William. Come on, Kim.
Oh, hi, Wendy.
Oh, Kim. The dollar value is now tripled. The top four answers are on the board. William, you need to get your family in this game. Name something of which a man might have a collection. William?
Stamps.
Let me see stamps. There it is. Two answers give you control. Name something of which a man might have a collection, Kim.
Cars.
Let me see cars.
Yes.
Not there. Come over to the Mulligan family.
Ooh.
We're going to pick up the pace here, Charles.
Ray, I'll say coin collection.
Let me see coins. Number one. Charles. What do you say? What do you say, Charles? 3 seconds.
I'll say children. That's what I did.
You know, you can get arrested for that now, Charles. Okay. Show me children.
Come on, John.
Ray, I'll say gun collection.
Yeah.
Let me see. Guns. One answer, Susan. You're going to be in this game.
Baseball cards.
Let me see baseball cards. Here we go. With another face-off. $1 value is now tripled. The top three answers are on the board. Besides cookies and crackers, name something kept in a cookie jar. Jim.
Money.
Let me see. Money. There's nothing. Sandy, give me an answer.
I know this is, I didn't really hear the
Besides cookies and crackers, name something kept in a cookie jar.
Cookies and crackers in a... We can't say pass this time, can we? Cookies and crackers...
3 seconds.
Marble,
right? One. Bill, besides cookies and crackers, something kept in a cookie jar. 3 seconds.
Bonds.
You say bonds?
Yeah.
All right, show me bonds. You're going to get a chance to steal if Wendy doesn't have an answer.
Cookies and crackers and...
Name something else kept in a cookie jar. 3 seconds, Wendy.
Candy.
Let me see.
Candy.
Kim, you're going to play for $5,000 if you tell me number three. 3 seconds. Okay. Mulligan, you're going to win the game. If you can tell me, besides cookies and crackers, something kept in a cookie jar.
Shot in the dark, cereal.
Cereal, Jim.
Tea bags.
Tea bags, Susan.
Coffee.
Jewelry.
Jewelry. What are you going to say, Charles? You'll win the game if you can tell me this.
I'm going to say cereal.
You're going to say cereal.
Right.
If it's there, you're playing for $5,000. Show me... Cereal. You don't have to be sorry. What is number three? Keys, which no one said. Thank your family so much for coming all the way from New York. We've got nice partying gifts for you. I will. God bless you, folks. Thank you, guys. You're a great family. I need two players for $5,000. Who's playing first?
Let's go.
Goodbye, Jim. The Wood family playing Fast Money right after this. Don't go away. We're back with the Wood family playing Fast Money for $5,000. 15 seconds on the clock. Good luck, Sandy.
Thank you, Ray.
Name a state people visit because of its autumn foliage.
New England.
Something people put in backyards.
Swings.
The number of hours in a school day.
5.
Something people rent at the beach.
Bicycles.
An intelligent animal.
Whale.
Turn around here, Sandy. Name a state people visit because of its autumn foliage, you said? New England, the state of New England. Our survey said... I guess they broke away and formed a whole area up there now called a region.
Yeah, well...
Something people put in backyards, you said?
Swings.
Swings, our survey said... Right. The number of hours in a school day, you said? 5. Survey said? 8.
Yeah.
Something people rent at the beach, you said?
Bicycles.
You said bicycles. Our survey said?
That's pretty good.
0. This is a lot like last time. You got 200. This time you got 20.
Yeah.
2s and zeros. You're just missing 1 0.
Yeah.
An intelligent animal, you said the very intelligent.
Whale.
How'd they get trapped in the North Pole? I don't know.
Yeah, right. But they were smart enough to get out.
We got them out, remember?
They used it.
Okay, our survey said...
This is bad, I knew it!
It is not bad.
This is...
Go over here, your team.
Okay, Mom. Sandy,
over there. Come here, Jim. Look straight ahead, my friend. You know how your mother-in-law got 200 points all by herself?
Yes.
It's your turn.
Thank you.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Revealing your partner's answers. I could let you look, it really wouldn't matter.
Be a star, Jim.
Think about this. Clear your mind.
Okay.
Name a state people visit because of its autumn foliage.
Massachusetts.
Something people put in backyards.
Dogs.
A number of hours in a school day.
6.
Something people rent at the beach.
Umbrella.
An intelligent animal.
A dog.
Turn around here. You need 180.
Come on.
Name a state people visit because of its autumn foliage. You said? Massachusetts. It's a lovely state. Our survey said? 7. Number one answer was Vermont. Something people put in backyards. You said? Dogs. Our survey said? 7.
7 people.
The number one answer was a pool. I asked you the number of hours in a school day. You said? 6. Survey said? 45.
All right. Come on.
Number one answer was 6 hours. Something people rent at the beach. You said? They rent umbrellas. What did our survey say?
Yeah, Jim.
40.
Over 100.
Umbrella, the number one answer. It comes down to the last question. I love these big finishes. You need 81 points.
Yeah.
An intelligent animal, you said? A dog. Of 81 people out of 100 said a dog. You got $5,000. What I'm telling you is you don't got the cash, but you're going That's for okay. $5 a point. Our survey said?
Okay.
18. The number one answer was a monkey. 137 points at $5 a point. You got
$85.
Come out here and hug
it. All right, come on.
We're gonna come right back. Don't you go away.
Some of our departing families will receive Maine wood shoes, handcrafted in Maine, made with prime American leather linings and uppers for quality and comfort from Maine Woods Koalas. Hoover's Spirit Portable Canister Vacuum for powerful suction and incredible mobility. It's light enough to carry anywhere you clean from Hoover. The look of Bob Mitchell designs from traditional to contemporary. Hand-screened wallpaper and fabrics in the latest fashion and colors from Bob Mitchell Designs. Advanced Formula Centrum with more vitamins and minerals, including beta-carotene. Centrum more complete from A to Zinc. Brushing with the Butler Gum Toothbrush helps fight plaque and reduce gum disease. Butler Gum, the better brush. Texan fruit juices, 100% pure and all natural. Enjoy a refreshing glass. Goodness grows under the Texan. Television City in Hollywood. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.